एंड रामचंद्रन 1922 to 2001। जी एन रामचंद्रन एन आउटस्टैंडिंग फिगर इन द फील्ड ऑफ प्रोटीन स्ट्रक्चर वॉज द फाउंडर ऑफ द मद्रास स्कूल ऑफ कन्फर्मेशनल एनालिसिस ऑफ बायोपॉलीमर्स। हिज डिस्कवरी ऑफ द ट्रिपल हेलिकल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कोलाजन पब्लिश्ड इन नेचुरे इन 1954 एंड हिज एनालिसिस ऑफ द अलाउड कन्फर्मेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन थ्रू द यूज ऑफ रामचंद्रन प्लॉट रैंक अमंग द मोस्ट आउटस्टैंडिंग कंट्रीब्यूशन इन स्ट्रक्चरल बायोलॉजी। ही वॉज बॉर्न ऑन October 8, 1922 इन अ स्मॉल टाउन नॉट फार फ्रॉम कोलचीन ऑन द साउथ वेस्टर्न कोस्ट ऑफ इंडिया। हिज फादर वॉज अ प्रोफेसर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स एट अ लोकल कॉलेज एंड दस हैड कंसिडरेबल इन्फ्लुएंस इन शेपिंग रामचंद्रन्स इंटरेस्ट इन मैथमेटिक्स। आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग हिज स्कूल ईयर्स रामचंद्रन ग्रेजुएट इन 1942 एज द टॉप रैंकिंग स्टूडेंट इन द BSc ऑनर्स फिजिक्स कोर्स ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मद्रास। He received a PhD from Cambridge University in 1949. While at Cambridge, Ramchandran met Linnaeus Pauling and was deeply influenced by his publication on models of the alpha helix and beta sheet structures that directed his attention to solving the structure of collagen. He passed away at the age of 78 on April 7, 2001. Chapter 8 Cell, the Unit of Life. When you look around, you see both living and non-living things. You must have wondered and asked yourself, what is it that makes an organism living, or what is it that makes an inanimate thing does not have, which a living thing has? The answer to this is the presence of the basic unit of life, the cell, in all living organisms. All organisms are composed of cells. Some are composed of a single cell and are called unicellular organisms, while others, like us, composed of many cells and are called multicellular organisms. 8.1 What is a cell? Unicellular organisms are capable of independent existence and performing the essential function of life. Anything less than a complete structure of a cell does not ensure independent living. Hence, cell is the fundamental structural and the functional unit of all living organisms. Anton von Leeuwenhoek first saw and described a live cell. Robert Brown later discovered the nucleus. The invention of the microscope and its improvement lead to the electron microscope revealed all the structural details of the cell. 8.2 Cell Theory. In 1838, Matthias Schleiden, a German botanist, examined a large number of plants and observed that all plants are composed of different kinds of cells, which form the tissues of the plant. At about same time, Theodore Schwann, 1839, a British zoologist, studied different types of animal cells and reported that cells has a thin outer layer which is today known as plasma membrane. He also concluded, based on his studies on plant tissue, that the presence of cell wall is a unique character of the plant cell. On the basis of this, Schwann proposed the hypothesis that the bodies of animals and plants are composed of cells and products of cells. Schleiden and Schwann together formulated the cell theory. This theory, however, did not explain as to how new cells were formed. Rudolf Virchow, 1855, first explained that cells divide and the new cells are formed from pre-existing cells, omnis cellula e cellula. He modified the hypothesis of Schleiden and Schwann to give the cell theory a final shape. Cell theory, as understood today, is all living organisms are composed of cells and products of cells. All cells arise from pre-existing cells. 8.3 An overview of cell. You have earlier observed cells in an onion peel and or human cheek cells under the microscope. Let us recollect their structure. The onion cell, which is a typical plant cell, has a distinct cell wall at its outer as its outer boundary, and just within it is the cell membrane. The cells of the human cheek have an outer membrane as the delimiting structure of the cell. Inside each cell is the dense membrane-bound structure called nucleus. This nucleus contains the chromosome, which in turn contain the genetic material, DNA. Cells that have membrane-bound nuclei are called eukaryotic, whereas cells that lack a membrane-bound nucleus are prokaryotic. In both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell, a semi-fluid matrix called cytoplasm occupies the volume of the cell. The cytoplasm is the main arena of cellular activity in both plants and animal cells. Various chemical reactions occur in it to keep the cell in a living state. Beside the nucleus, the eukaryotic cell have other membrane-bound distinct structure called organelles, like the endoplasmic reticulum, ER, the Golgi complex, lysosome, mitochondria, microbodies, and vacuoles. The prokaryotic cell lacks such membrane-bound organelles. Ribosome are non-membrane-bound organelle found in all cells, both eukaryotic as well as prokaryotic. Within the cell, ribosomes are found not only in the cytoplasm but also within the two organelles, cytoplasm in plants and mitochondria and on rough endoplasmic reticulum. Animal cells contain another non-membrane-bound organelle called centrosome, which help in cell division. Cells differ greatly in size, shape and activities. Figure 8.1. For example, mycoplasmas, the smallest cell, are only 0.3 micrometer in length, while bacteria could be 3 to 5 micrometer. The largest isolated single cell is the egg of an ostrich. Among multicellular organisms, human red blood cells are about 7 micrometer in diameter. Nerve cells are some of the longest cell. Cell also vary greatly in their shape. They may be disc-like, polygonal, columnar, cuboidal, thread-like, or even irregular. The shape of the cell may vary with the function they perform. 8.4. Prokaryotic cell. The prokaryotic cell are represented by bacteria, blue-green algae, mycoplasma, and PPLO, pleuropneumonia-like organisms. They are generally smaller and multiply more rapidly than the eukaryotic cell. Figure 8.2. They may vary greatly in shape and size. The four basic shapes of bacteria are bacillus, rod-like, coccus, spherical, vibrio, comma-shaped, and spiral. The organization of the prokaryotic cell is fundamentally similar, even though prokaryotes exhibit a wide variety of shapes and functions. All prokaryotes have a cell wall surrounding the cell membrane except in mycoplasma. The fluid matrix filling the cell is the cytoplasm. There is no well-defined nucleus. The genetic material is basically naked, not enveloped by a nuclear membrane. In addition to the genomic DNA, the single chromosome circular DNA, many bacteria have small circular DNA outside the genomic DNA. These smaller DNA are called plasmids. The plasmid DNA confers certain unique phenotypic characters to such bacteria. One such character is resistance to antibiotics. In higher classes, you will learn that this plasmid DNA is used to monitor bacterial transformation with foreign DNA. Nuclear membrane is found in eukaryotes. No organelle like the one in eukaryote are found in prokaryotic cells except for ribosomes. Prokaryotes have something unique in the form of inclusions. A specialized differentiated form of the cell membrane called mesosome is a characteristic of prokaryotes. They are essentially infoldings of the cell membrane. 8.4.1 Cell envelope and its modification. Most prokaryotic cells, particularly the bacterial cell, have a chemically complex cell envelope. The cell envelope consists of the tightly bound three-layered structure, that is the outermost glycocalyx, followed by the cell wall and then the plasma membrane. Although each layer of the envelope perform distinct function, they act together as a single protective unit. Bacteria can be classified into two groups on the basis of differences in their cell envelope and the manner in which they respond to the staining procedure developed by Gram. Where those that take up the Gram stain are Gram positive and other that do not are called Gram negative bacteria. Glycocalyx differ in composition and thickness among different bacteria. It could be a loose sheath called the slime layer in some, while in other it may be thick and tough called the capsule. The cell wall determine the shape of the cell and provide a strong structural support to prevent the bacterium from bursting or collapsing. The plasma membrane is selectively permeable in nature and interact with the outside world. This membrane is similar structure to that of the eukaryotes. A special membranous structure is the mesosome, which is formed by the inclusion of the plasma membrane in the cell. These extensions are in a form of vesicles, tubules, and lamellae. They help in cell wall formation, DNA replication, and distribution to daughter cells. They also help in respiration, secretion processes to increase the surface area of the plasma membrane and enzymatic content. In some prokaryotes, like cyanobacteria, there are other membranous extensions into the cytoplasm called chromatophores, which contain pigments. Bacterial cell may be motile or non-motile. If motile, they have thin filamentous extension from their cell wall called flagella. Bacteria show a range in a number and arrangement of flagella. Bacterial flagellum is composed of three parts: filament, hook, and basal body. The filament is the longest portion and extend from the cell surface to the outside. Beside flagella, pili and fimbriae are also surface structures of the bacteria but do not play a role in motility. The pili are elongated tubular structure made of special protein. The fimbriae are small bristle-like fibers sprouting out of the cell. In some bacteria, they are known to help attach the bacteria to rocks in stream and also to the host tissues. 8.4.2 Ribosome and inclusion bodies. In prokaryotes, ribosomes are associated with the plasma membrane of the cell. They are about 15 nanometer by 20 nanometer in size and are made up of two subunits, 50S and 30S units, which when present together form 70S prokaryotic ribosome. Ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis. Several ribosomes may attach to the single mRNA and form a chain called polyribosome or polysome. The ribosome of the polysome translate the mRNA into protein. Inclusion bodies, reserve food material in prokaryotic cell are stored in the cytoplasm in the form of inclusion bodies. These are not bound by any membrane system and lie free in the cytoplasm. Example: phosphate granules, cyanofusion granules, and glycogen granules. Gas vacuole are found in blue-green and purple and green photosynthetic bacteria. 8.5 Eukaryotic cell. The eukaryotes include all the protists, plant, animals, and fungi. In eukaryotic cell, there is an extensive compartmentalization of cytoplasm, though the presence of membrane-bound organelles. Eukaryotic cell possesses an organized nucleus with a nuclear envelope. In addition, eukaryotic cells have a variety of complex locomotory and cytoskeletal structures. Their genetic material is organized into chromosomes. All eukaryotic cells are not identical. Plants and animal cells are different, as the former possess cell wall plastered in a large central vacuole while are absent in animals, which are absent in animal cells. On the other hand, animal cells have centriole, which are absent in almost all plant cells. Figure 8.3. Let us now look at individual cell organelle to understand their structure and functions. 8.5.1 Cell membrane. The detailed structure of the membrane was studied only after the advent of the electron microscope in the 1950s. Meanwhile, chemical studies on the cell membrane, especially in human red blood cells, RBCs, enable the scientists to deduce the possible structure of plasma membrane. These studies show that the cell membrane is mainly composed of lipids and proteins. The major lipids are phospholipids that are arranged in a bilayer. Also, the lipids are arranged within the membrane with the polar head towards the outer side and the hydrophobic tail towards the inner part. This ensures that the nonpolar tail of saturated hydrocarbon is protected from the aqueous environment. Figure 8.4. In addition to phospholipids, membrane also contain cholesterol. Later, biochemical investigation clearly revealed that the cell membrane also possesses protein and carbohydrates. The ratio of protein and lipids vary considerably in different cell types. In human beings, the membrane of the erythrocyte has approximately 52% protein and 40% lipids. Depending on the age of extraction, membrane protein can be classified as integral and peripheral. Peripheral proteins lie on the surface of membrane while the integral protein are partially or totally buried in the membrane. An improved model of the structure of cell membrane was proposed by Singler and Nicholson. 1972, widely accepted as fluid mosaic model. Figure 8.4. According to this, the quasi-fluid nature of lipid enables lateral movement of protein within the overall bilayer. This ability to move within the membrane is measured as its fluidity. The fluid nature of the membrane is also important from the point of view of function like cell growth, formation of intercellular junctions, secretion, endocytosis, cell division, etc. One of the most important functions of the plasma membrane is the transport of the molecule across it. The membrane is selectively permeable to some molecule present on either side of it. Many molecules can move briefly across the membrane without any requirement of energy, and this is called the passive transport. Neutral solutes may move across the membrane by the process of simple diffusion along the concentration gradient, that is, from higher concentration to the lower. Water may also move across this membrane from higher concentration, from higher to lower concentration. Movement of water by diffusion is called osmosis. As the polar molecule cannot pass through the nonpolar lipid bilayer, they require a carrier protein of the membrane to facilitate their transport across the membrane. A few ion or molecules are transported across the membrane against their concentration gradient, that is, from lower to the higher concentration. Such a transport is an energy-dependent process in which ATP is utilized and is called active transport, example NAK+ pump. 8.5.2 Cell wall. As you may recall, a non-living rigid structure called the cell wall forms the outer covering for the plasma membrane of fungi and plants. Cell wall not only gives shape to the cell and protect the cell from mechanical damage and infection, it also helps in cell-to-cell interaction and provide barrier to undesirable macromolecules. Algae have cell wall made up of cellulose, galactans, mannans, and minerals like calcium carbonate, while in other plants it consists of cellulose, hemicellulose, pectin, and proteins. The cell wall of a young plant cell, the primary wall, is capable of growth which gradually diminishes as the cell matures, and the secondary wall is formed on the inner towards membrane side of the cell. The middle lamella is the layer mainly of calcium pectate which hold or glues the different neighboring cells together. The cell wall and middle lamellae may be traversed by plasmodesmata which connect the cytoplasm of neighboring cells. 8.5.3 Endomembrane system. While each of the membranous organelles is distinct in terms of its structure and function, many of these are considered together as an endomembrane system because their functions are coordinated. The endomembrane system include endoplasmic reticulum, ER, Golgi complex, lysosome, and vacuole. Since the function of the mitochondria, chloroplast, and peroxisomes are not coordinated with the above components, these are not considered as a part of endomembrane system. 8.5.3.1 The endoplasmic reticulum, ER. Electron microscopic studies of eukaryotic cells reveal the presence of network or reticulum of tiny tubular structures scattered in the cytoplasm that is called the endoplasmic reticulum, ER, figure 8.5. Hence, ER divide the intracellular space into two distinct compartments, that is, luminal inside ER and extraluminal cytoplasmic compartment. The ER often shows ribosomes attached to their outer surface. The endoplasmic reticulum bearing ribosomes on their surface is called rough endoplasmic reticulum, RER. In the absence of ribosome, they appear smooth and are called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. RER is frequently observed in a cell actively involved in protein synthesis and secretion. They are extensive and continuous with the outer membrane of the nucleus. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum is the major site for the synthesis of lipid. In animal cells, lipid-like steroidal hormones are synthesized in SER. 8.5.3.2 Golgi apparatus. Camelio Golgi, 1898, first observed densely stained reticular structure near the nucleus. These were later named Golgi bodies after him. They consist of many flat disc-shaped sac or cisternae or of 0.5 micrometer to 1 micrometer diameter, figure 8.6. These are stacked parallel to each other. Varied number of cisternae present in the Golgi complex. The Golgi cisternae are concentrically arranged near the nucleus with distinct convex cis or the forming face and the concave trans or the maturing face. The cis and the trans phase of the organelle are entirely different but interconnected. The Golgi apparatus principally perform the function of packaging material to be delivered either to the intracellular targets or secreted outside the cell. Materials to be packaged in the form of vesicles form the RER, fuse with the cis phase of the Golgi apparatus and move towards the maturing phase. This explains why the Golgi apparatus remain in close association with the endoplasmic reticulum. A number of proteins synthesized by ribosomes on the endoplasmic reticulum are modified in the cisternae of the Golgi apparatus before they are released from its trans phase. Golgi apparatus is an important site of formation of glycoproteins and glycolipids. 8.5.3.3 Lysosomes. These are membrane-bound vesicular structure formed by the process of packaging of the Golgi apparatus. The isolated lysosomal vesicles have been found to be very rich in almost all type of hydrolytic enzyme, hydrolases, lipases, proteases, carbohydrases, optimally active at the acidic pH. These enzymes are capable of digesting carbohydrate, proteins, lipids and nucleic acids. 8.5.3.4 Vacuoles. The vacuole is the membrane-bound space found in the cytoplasm. It contains water, sap, excretory product and other materials not useful for the cell. The vacuole is bound by the single membrane called tonoplast. In plant cell, the vacuole can occupy up to 90% of the volume of a cell. In plants, the tonoplast facilitates the transport of the number of ions and other material against concentration gradient into the vacuole. Hence, their concentration is significantly higher in the vacuole than in the cytoplasm. In amoeba, the contractile vacuole is important for osmoregulation and excretion. In many cells, as in protists, food vacuoles are formed by engulfing the food particles. 8.5.4 Mitochondria. Mitochondria, unless specifically stained, are not easily visible under the microscope. The number of mitochondria per cell is variable depending on the physiological activity of the cell. In terms of shape and size also, considerable degree of variability is observed. Typically, it is sausage shape or cylindrical, having a diameter of 0.2 to 1 micrometer, average 0.5 micrometer and length 1 to 4.1 micrometer. Each mitochondrion is a double membrane bound structure with the outer membrane and the inner membrane dividing its lumen distinctly into two aqueous compartments, that is outer compartment and the inner compartment. The inner compartment is filled with the dense homogeneous substances called the matrix. The outer membrane forms the continuous limiting boundary of the organelle. The inner membrane forms a number of infoldings called the cristae. Towards the matrix, figure 8.7, the cristae increase the surface area. The two membranes have their own specific enzyme associated with the mitochondrial function. Mitochondria are the site of aerobic respiration. They produce cellular energy in the form of ATP, hence they are called powerhouse of the cells. The matrix also possesses single circular DNA molecule, a few RNA molecules, ribosomes 70S and the components required for the synthesis of protein. The mitochondria divides by fission. 8.5.5 Plastids. Plastids are found in all plant cells and in euglenoids. These are easily observed under the microscope as they are large. They bear some specific pigments, thus imparting specific color to the plant. Based on the type of pigment, plastids can be classified into chloroplast, chromoplast, and leucoplast. The chloroplast contain chlorophyll and carotenoid pigment, which are responsible for trapping light energy essential for photosynthesis. In the chromoplast, fat-soluble carotenoid pigment like carotene, xanthophyll, and other are present. This gives the part of the plant a yellow, orange, or red color. The leucoplast are the colorless plastid of varied shape and size, with stored nutrients. Ameloplasts store carbohydrates, starch, example potato. Elioplasts store oil and fats, were the alloroplasts store proteins. Majority of the chloroplasts of the green plant are found in the mesophyll cells of the leaves. These are lens-shaped, oval, spherical, discoid, or even ribbon-like organelle having variable length 5 to 10 micrometer and width 2 to 4 micrometer. Their number varies from 1 per cell of Chlamydomonas, a green alga, to 20 to 40 per cell in the mesophyll. Like mitochondria, the chloroplasts are also double membrane bound. Of the two, the inner chloroplast membrane is relatively less permeable. The space limited by the inner membrane of the chloroplast is called the stroma. A number of organized flattened membranous sacs called the thylakoids are present in the stroma. Figure 8.8. Thylakoids are arranged in stalks like the piles of the coin called grana, single granum, or the integranal thylakoid. In addition, there are flat membranous tubules called the stroma lamellae connecting the thylakoid of the different grana. The membrane of the thylakoids encloses space called a lumen. The stroma of the chloroplast containing enzyme require for the synthesis of carbohydrate and protein. It also contains small double-stranded circular DNA molecule and ribosome. Chlorophyll pigment are present in the thylakoids. The ribosomes of the chloroplast are smaller, 70S, than the cytoplasmic ribosomes, 80S. 8.5.6 Ribosomes. Ribosomes are the granular structure first observed under the electron microscope as dense particles by George Pallad, 1953. They are composed of ribonucleic acid, RNA, and protein and are not surrounded by any membrane. The eukaryotic ribosome are 80S, while the prokaryotic ribosomes are 70S. Each ribosome has two subunits, larger and smaller subunit. Figure 8.9. The two subunits of 80S ribosomes are 60S and 40S, while that of 70S ribosomes are 50S and 30S. Here, S, Svedberg's unit, stands for the sedimentation coefficient. It is indirectly a measure of density and size. Both 70S and 80S ribosomes are composed of two subunits. 8.5.7 Cytoskeleton. An elaborate network of filamentous proteinaceous structure consisting of microtubule, microfilament, and intermediate filament present in the cytoplasm is collectively referred to as cytoskeleton. The cytoskeleton in the cell are involved in many functions such as mechanical support, motility, maintenance of the shape of the cell. 8.5.8 Cilia and flagella. Cilia and flagella are hair-like outgrowths of the cell membrane. Cilia are small structure which work like oars causing the movement of either the cell or the surrounding fluid. Flagella are comparatively longer and responsible for cell movement. In prokaryotic bacteria also possess the flagella, but these are structurally different from that of eukaryotic flagella. The electron microscopic study of the cilium or the flagellum show that they are covered with plasma membrane. Their core, called the exoneme, possesses a number of microtubules running parallel to the longitudinal axis. The exoneme usually has 9 doublets of radially arranged peripheral microtubules and a pair of centrally located microtubules. Such an arrangement of exonemal microtubules is referred to as 9 plus 2 array. Figure 8.10. Central microtubules are connected by bridge and is also enclosed by the central sheath, which is connected to one of its tubule of each peripheral doublet by the radial spokes. Thus, there are 9 radial spokes. The peripheral doublet are also interconnected by linkers. Both the cilium and flagellum emerge from centriole-like structure called the basal bodies. 8.5.9 Centrosome and centrioles. Centrosome is an organelle usually contain two cylindrical structure called centrioles. These are surrounded by amorphous pericentriolar material. Both the centrioles in a centrosome lie perpendicular to each other, in which each has an organization like the cartwheel. They are made up of 9 evenly spaced peripheral fibrils of tubulin protein. Each of the peripheral fibril is a triplet. The adjacent triplet is also are also linked. The central part of the proximal region of the centriole is also proteinaceous and is called the hub, which are connected with the tubule of the peripheral triplet by radial spokes made of protein. The centrioles from the basal body of cilia or flagella and the spindle fibers that arise of that give rise to spindle apparatus during the cell division in animal cells. 8.5.10 Nucleus. Nucleus as an cell organelle was first described by Robert Brown as early as 1831. Later, the material of the nucleus staining by the basic dyes was given the name chromatin by Fleming. The interphase nucleus of the cell when it is not dividing has highly extended and elaborated nucleoprotein fiber called chromatin, nuclear matrix and one or more spherical body called nucleoli, single nucleolus, figure 8.11. Electron microscopy has revealed that the nuclear envelope, which consists of two parallel membrane with a space between 10 to 50 nanometer called the perinuclear space, form a barrier between the material present inside the nucleus and that of the cytoplasm. The outer membrane usually remain continuous with the endoplasmic reticulum and also bear ribosomes on it. At a number of places, the nuclear envelope is interrupted by minute pores, which are formed by the fusion of its two membranes. These nuclear pores are the passage through which the movement of RNA and protein molecules takes place in both the directions between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Normally, there is only one nucleus per cell. Variation in the number of nucleus are also nuclei are also frequently observed. Can you recollect name of organisms that have more than one nucleus per cell? Some mature cells even lack nucleus. Example, erythrocytes of many mammals and sieve tube cells of vascular plants. Would you consider these cells as living? The nuclear matrix or the nucleoplasm contain nucleolus and the chromatin. The nucleoli are spherical structure present in the nucleoplasm. The content of nucleolus is continuous with the rest of the nucleoplasm and it is not a membrane-bound structure. It is a site for active ribosomal RNA synthesis. Larger and more numerous nucleoli are present in cell actively carrying out protein synthesis. You may recall that the interphase nucleus has a loose and indistinct network of nucleoprotein fiber called chromatin. But during different stages of cell division, cells show structured chromosomes in place of nucleus. Chromatin contains DNA and some basic protein called histones, some non-histone protein and also RNA. A single human cell has approximately 2 meter long thread of DNA distributed among its 46-23 pair chromosomes. You will study the detail of DNA packaging in the form of a chromosome in class 12th. Every chromosome visible only in dividing cell essentially has a primary constriction or the centromere on the sides of which disc-shaped structure called kinetochores are present. Figure 8.12. Centromere hold two chromatid of a chromosome. Based on the position of centromere, the chromosome can be classified into four types. Figure 8.13. The metacentric chromosome has middle centromere forming the two equal arms of the chromosome. The submetacentric chromosome has centromere slightly away from the middle of the chromosome, resulting into one shorter arm and one longer arm. In case of acrocentric chromosome, the centromere is situated close to its end, forming one extremely short and one very long arm, whereas the telocentric chromosome has a terminal centromere. Sometimes a few chromosome has non-staining secondary constriction at a constant location. This gives the appearance of a small fragment called the satellite. 8.5.11 Microbodies. Many membrane-bound minute vesicles called microbodies that contain various enzymes are present in both plants and animal cells.